this word. Job 1 verse 8 reads, and the Lord said unto Satan, has thou considered my servant Job? That there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil. Man, he runs from evil. He turned away from it like Joseph. Then Satan answered the Lord and said, do Job fear God for not? Has thou not made an edge about him and about his house and about all that he hath on every side? That's why the devil can't get to y'all. Has blessed the work of his hands, and his substance is increased in the land. But put forth thine hand now and touch all that he hath, and he will curse thee to thy face. Verse 18, while he was yet speaking, there came also another and said, thy sons and thy daughters were eating and drinking wine in their eldest brother's house, and behold, there came a great wind from the wilderness and smote the four corners of the house, and it fell on the young men, and they are dead, and I alone am only to escape to tell thee. Verse 20, then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down on the ground and cursed God and cried all night and complained all day. He fell on the ground and worshiped. Job 2:10, but he said unto his wife, going off on him, thou speak as one of the foolish women speak. What shall we receive good at the hand of God? And shall we not receive evil? And all of this did Job sin not with his lips. I want to use as a title of today's message, everything is happening right on time. Everything is happening right on time. Every storm, every tragedy, every heartbreak, everything that calls a hallelujah, everything that brings tears to my eyes, everything that makes me have to file bankruptcy, everything that makes me have to stay up in the middle of the night, everything is happening right on time. See, God is not surprised by anything that's happening to us because he gave the devil permission to let it happen. The attacks on Job about his righteousness. After there was a conversation about his living, his blessings. After there was a conversation about his relationship with God. Then right on cue, right on time, the attacks start coming. It doesn't take God by surprise when you're going through what you're going through. You just gotta sit back and know that everything that's happening is in the hands of God. They went no good. Everything happened right on time. And what it says in 1 Corinthians 4 and 5. 1 Corinthians 4 and 5, it says, just therefore, somebody shout, therefore. Since you understand that everything is happening right on time, therefore, judge nothing before time. Don't you judge your storm. Don't you judge the hell you facing. Don't you judge trauma that you're going through. Judge nothing before time, because when it's all said and done, that is the thing that's going to take you to another level. The thing that you hated, the thing that you cried out right on time. How about somebody say it came right on time? Oh God, stop judging your storm. Stop judging your storm. Your storm is right on time. Tell somebody, stop judging your storm. You needed it when it happened. You needed it every day it happened. Every time it came. Every time it hurt your heart. You needed this storm to make you have the prayer life that you got right now. To make you the worshiper you are right now. In your life, you needed that two-faced person in your life. You needed that storm to hit you like it hit you, because it gave you some backbone, it gave you some determination, it gave you some motivation to shake the dust off your feet. God Almighty, because everything that God allows to happen is in the forecast. It's in the forecast, baby. It's in the forecast. I'm not surprised by what happens because it's preordained. It's already in the forecast. Can I give you four elements that's always right on time? I'm giving you four elements that's always right on time. Number one, prayer is always right on time. Prayer is always right on time. The Bible said men should always pray and never debate. Prayer is right on time. This is what happened with Moses. The people sinned before God, and God was getting ready to cut them off. But Moses reminded the people something. And Moses said, and the Lord was very angry with Aaron to have destroyed him. And I prayed for Aaron also at the same time. I didn't know God was getting ready to cut Aaron off. I didn't know when Aaron was leaving the door, he was about to be in a bad accident.
Sharing the, some of these things many times, but I've never seen her
Almighty. See, sometimes the people need it more than you do. Oh, God. We around here sitting up taking everything, and somebody else just needs somebody to say, I appreciate you. I thank God for you. I couldn't be what I am without you. Sometimes it can always be about ourselves. We got to look in the crowd and see who else. Somebody shout, who else? I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Number three, speaking up is always right on time. Speaking up, oh, this is what Kanita was in right now. This was in Esther 4 and 14. This is what Mordecai told the woman of God that got her position, that had everything she wanted, because he said she didn't need nobody else at this moment. She was about to risk everything. This is what the man of God told her. He said, for your vow altogether, holdest thou speech at this time. Oh, we need you to speak up. We need you to speak up and say, hey, you some kin to us. We need your opinion. We need you to speak up. An enlargement and deliverance shall arise to the Jews from another place. But now thy father's house shall be destroyed, and who knoweth whether thou art come to the kingdom for a time such as this. Listen, I say, why are you here? Why are you here? You may be here for a time such as this. You may be here for a time to be a blessing to somebody that I can't bless, that I can't reach, but you can reach it with your story. With your testimony, you can reach them how you were molested. You can release them how you had to raise the children by yourself at an early age. You need to speak up, because somebody needs to hear your testimony. Somebody needs to hear what you have gone through, so you can be a blessing to them while they're going through by themselves. Malcolm X spoke up. Martin Luther King spoke up. Rosa Parks spoke up. You got to learn how to speak up. Somebody needs your anointing that's in you. Speak up, oh God, I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Number four, backstabbers are always right on time. They're right on time, they ain't slick, they ain't undercover, they're right on time. They right when I need them. They right when God said do it. They right on time. Watch this. Matthew 26:18. And he said to Jesus, talking, go into the city to such a man. And said to him, the master said, my time. Jesus said, my time is at hand. He said, I'm ready to die now. My time is at hand. He said, I will keep the Passover at the house with my disciples. Talking about the Lord's Supper. He said, my time is at hand. He said, I'm about to have Passover. I'm going to get to eat. Say, enter. Say, thank he got. He was about to take them by surprise. Same thing. It's a sneak attack. And Jesus already said, my time is at hand. Same thing. He done pays Judas and said, I'm ready now, brother. He think he gave the cold word, and now he's about to slip up on Jesus. Jesus already said, my time is come. Right on. of the clock. Every peak has an assignment to it. That's why we tell you, you got to take a licking and keep on ticking. Can I give you the five dimensions of time that's found in the Bible? Give you the five dimensions of time. Number one is the appointed time. It's an appointed time. Smash out everything happening right on time. Habakkuk 2 and 3. For the vision is yet for the appointed time. But at the end it shall speak and shall not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it. Because it shall surely come, it will not tarry. That's why the words like the group of the country, waiting and patience is so powerful in the Bible. It's because you got to wait. It's already been assigned. It's already happening, but you got to wait. Jesus said, in your patience, possess ye your souls. Now, the appointed time, the Hebrew word for appointment is in the word meeting. That's why even today, when we have to meet with the doctor or the dentist or the lawyer, we have to set an appointment.
Time.
Then She's been waiting on a hook. So the harvest, the harvest came when you're married. He took it from the process. Then he manifested with the fullness of time. The fullness of time. I didn't see if she worked it. Did she, does she have the character? Does she have the right attitude? Does she have the right spirit? That comes after a fullness. It's going to happen day one. Lust can happen day one. Can he stand a storm? Don't happen day one. That only comes from the fullness of time. Yeah, bring the baby over. Now, let's say they want a baby, so they got to go through the process. That ain't no day one event. That happens over a process. Before the baby gets to this day, they want to send the baby to a certain school. Before they can go through that, they got first, they got to conceive.
I'm ready for the fullness of time.
pray, you got to set yourself apart. You got to get holy. You want your harvest, but you still have crazy. God said it's 21%. You got to walk around the wilderness.
Yeah.
Does anybody here believe in miracles? I want you to take all the hell you've been going through. I want you to sit up to your feet. And I want you to turn around. And I want you to turn around until you feel it coming off. Until you feel it catching off. Until you feel it burning off. Until you feel it going away. Until you feel it breaking through. Until you